Hello everyone, welcome to the class of business forecasting. Today we will discuss exponential smoothing. In the previous session we discussed different type of moving average methods, and under moving average methods we discussed simple moving average, weighted moving average and exponential moving average, and we illustrated them with practical examples and using Excel also. Today we'll extend the time series data to a different model that is called exponential smoothing. It has a different structure of, you know, modeling, which is different than moving average. I'll give you the description of that and also the different idea between what extension we have been doing or we are doing in exponential smoothing as compared to the moving average also. That also I'll discuss, and then we'll illustrate the concept, the technical part of exponential smoothing, and also the Excel illustration. So what is exponential smoothing? In exponential smoothing, we actually assign the weight to the data exponentially, and initial period are being given maximum weightage, and then that will optimize, and then the weightage of the remaining period will be distributed in an exponential manner. Slowly it will reduce. So that means we give higher importance to the immediate data. That importance or the parameter we call it is a smoothing constant. So there we have to optimize that smoothing constant, we call it as alpha say, which lie between 0 to 1. So that means how much weightage you want to give to the immediate period. And in the exponential smoothing, we give highest weightage to the immediate period. You can see here that means that the recent data points are given more weightage compared to the older one. But exponentially, the weightage are been reduces or decreases to the past observations. But theoretically, you consider all the past data in your, you know, process of averaging and forecasting. But since the weightage are been decreasing in an exponential manner, we consider all the past data, we call it as exponential smoothing method. And, you know, another assumption is that data should be stationary. If you have a stationary data where the mean does not change over a period of time, standard deviation rate set out remain to some extent steady, it is better to use exponential smoothing model, or exponential smoothing model actually works very well with better accuracy or measure of accuracy. And the alpha range lies between 0 to 1. And when it comes to the exponential smoothing model, there are three, you know, different models are there. First is the simple exponential smoothing, which we are going to discuss today. And then we can extend that with more different type of data pattern, like we have discussed in the components of time series session, that data can be seasonal, data can have trend also. So in that case, there are different methods of exponential smoothing. If you have a data which is having trend, uptrend or downtrend, in that case, you can use whole exponential smoothing. If data has a seasonality and trend together, in that case, you can use the winter's hold method or winter exponential smoothing. In the forthcoming session, we will discuss these two concepts in detail, but today we will consider only simple exponential smoothing and how it is developed. So let's see. So as I mentioned that, you know, it gives some higher weightage to the immediate period, and slowly exponentially the weightage are being reduced or decreased to the older period, right? So calculation of the forecast are nothing but the weighted average of the immediate data and the forecast of the smoothed forecast of the immediate past period. So how come it has been developed? Just now I am talking, you might be confused that, you know, just now I talked about it's exponential series. It takes care of all the past data, but the weightage are been reduced in an exponential manner, right? It is decreased, but it theoretically we consider all the past data, whereas in moving average we consider the fixed amount of data. For example, suppose if you have a data like this, say y1, y2, y3, y4, y5, y6, y7, like this, ... So suppose if you take a 3-period moving average, so 3-period moving average is fixed, right? You make the forecast for y4 hat. Similarly, when you go for y5, you drop y1 and you consider y2, y3, y4 and you forecast y5. So this is what you drag the moving average. So 3-period are fixed now every time you are carrying forward. But older period you are dropping and new period you are adding, right? This is what the moving average. But in exponential smoothing, actually what you do, in exponential smoothing, actually you don't take the simple average of couple of past data. You actually, you know, suppose you are forecasting Y5, you take the weighted combination of the all the previous periods and you give a maximum weightage to the Y4, alpha weightage to the Y4. Similarly, if you go for the forecast of, say, you know, for the forecast of, say, Y7, Suppose you want to make forecast, you actually take all the past period and where you give maximum weightage to the Y6 alpha. So this way theoretically you consider all the period in your exponential smoothing process. This is what the difference between moving average and exponential smoothing. Now let's see the formula of exponential smoothing. If you look at the general formula, so alpha weightage you give to the immediate period. Suppose you are at Y7, you want to forecast for Y7, so Y6 you are giving alpha weightage, right? That you have to optimize. Look at this point. That you have to optimize. And also, if you think that you want to give more weightage to the immediate period, so you can increase the alpha value. If you want to give less weightage to the immediate period and you want to give importance to the older period, in that case, you can give some sort of lower weightage to the immediate period and you are giving importance to the older data, and you can also distribute the weights to the older data also. I will show you both examples today. But now, suppose imagine that we will optimize the alpha. So initially, you are assuming some value as alpha, say, here we have given alpha. And here the first period weightage is alpha, total weightage should not cross 100%, right? So alpha say 20% or 50%, so alpha you have given, the rest of the weight next period, the weightage will be alpha into 1 minus alpha, second will be alpha into 1 minus alpha square, then alpha into 1 minus alpha cube. So this way plus dot 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 dot. So this way you are actually spreading the data sets with exponential weights, and all data, past data, time series you are taking into account and you are making for the next period. This is what exponential smoothing model. But in general, you can write that in a short format like this. The past period forecast and alpha into the error term of that period. Suppose, for example, suppose you want to make forecast a Y7. Just now I talked about Y7 equals to Y6 forecast plus alpha, that weights are 20% weightage you have given to the immediate period, say alpha, into the error term. Say Y6 minus Y6 hat. So this is the error, this error term. So forecast of previous period plus alpha into error term. So this is the general structure. If you club this entire formula and you can create a generalized formula in an iterative process, it will come up with this forecast. This you can, let me illustrate that how actually this formula can be derived from here, or other way, this exponential series can be derived from this cluster formula, clubbed formula. Let's see. Suppose here I have written same formula again, how this is being derived or this has been developed through this formula, or other way, I will discuss that now. Suppose if you look at the screen here, so if you see here this formula, as I mentioned, the previous period forecast plus alpha into the error term, this is the error term, right? This is the error term. So now this I can illustrate like this, weighted sum also, alpha into actual plus 1 minus alpha into the forecast. So that means, say Y7, I was talking about Y7, say, so alpha into Y6 plus 1 minus alpha into Y6 hat. Simple way, it is easier to understand. So this is nothing but the weighted combination of the previous period actual and forecast. This formula I will keep in Excel and I will show the illustration in the numerical example. So rather than this formula, I will prefer this formula because it is easy to remember. So let's see this formula. So how we can derive it? So we can write like this, right? Now let's come here. So if you see this particular formula, this I have written as alpha into this yt, alpha yt plus 1 minus alpha yt hat. Just I have rearranged. Now I can write equals to alpha yt plus 1 minus alpha, I'll keep as it is. Now yt hat, I'll distribute yt minus 1 actual weighted combination of the previous period, 1 minus alpha yt minus 1 hat. I can write like this, right? So this is what, this is nothing but I have replaced this yt hat with the previous period combination. Just I have gone back to the data and I am replacing them. So yt hat is a combination of, say, y6 is a representative of, or you know, outcome of y5 actual and y5 forecast. So weighted combination of y5 data, fifth period data and forecast is nothing but the y6, same way I have written it. Look at here, it is nothing but alpha yt plus alpha into 1 minus alpha yt minus 1 plus 1 minus alpha square yt minus 1 hat. So this part are nothing but, if you see this part are nothing but this, actually this term, these two first two term of our series. So we got the first two term of our series. The rest how I'll get, I'll show you now. Only this part I'll show you the calculation. So let's bring the pen and you see here this part. Now what I'll do, 1 minus alpha square is as it is. Now this yt minus hat, I'll distribute, I'll take the combination of yt minus 2 actual and forecast. So what will be the formula then? Alpha into yt minus 2 actual plus 1 minus alpha yt minus 2 hat, right? I can write like this. So this yt minus 1 hat forecast I have replaced with the previous data yt minus 2 actual and yt minus 2 forecast. So that weighted combination I have again taken. Now if I distribute this part again, this part if I multiply, it will come like this part. This part will be as it is. Now this part, if you see, it is nothing but alpha into 1 minus alpha square and yt minus 2 plus 1 minus alpha to the power 3 is a cube into yt minus 2 forecast. So what we found actually, this part. Now if you look at, let me open the pen, the highlight point. Now if you look at this part are nothing but this terminology. So we got the third term also Marcinich. And now if you replace this yt minus 2 hat with yt minus 2, 3 combination, data combinations, you will get this term and dot, dot, dot. This is what, you know, the technical illustration of exponential smoothing. So theoretically, this model is the exponential smoothing formula, or this or that, anyone you can select, either of the three. So what I will do, I will select this one I will take. This formula I will take and carry forward to the, you know, Excel, because this formula is easy to understand. What is this formula? It's just weighted combination of previous period actual and the forecast. Once you select the weight, you can get that formula and you can get the forecast, and you can drag it, you will get the forecast using exponential smoothing. But theoretically, you are actually counting all the previous period wherever you are, whether it's the 10th period, first, say third period, or say even 30th period. You are actually taking all the previous period of that preceding data, and you are dragging the formula. That's it, the exponential smoothing model. Let's see one illustration to get a better clarity. So here you see, this is the formula, expanded formula of exponential smoothing time series data, time series model. Now suppose if you take say alpha, say 0.8. So if you give 0.8 to the immediate period, that means you are giving higher weightage to the immediate, 80% weightage to the immediate period. Remaining 20% you have to split to the older data, all the older data, whatever, at which stage you are there of iteration, that is not a matter. But initially, you have to give 80% weightage to the immediate data. Suppose you have finalized it. Suppose there is a trend in the data and you could see that you want to give, or say stock price. So you want to give more weightage to the immediate period, right? Every day it's raining. So in last day, if you had a rain, so you can expect that tomorrow also, today also there will be rain. So this way you can give more weightage to the immediate period, say. So suppose 80% weightage you have given to the immediate period. So then what will be the weight for the next period? The next period weight will be 0.8 into 1 minus 0.8, nothing but 0.8 into 0.2. So it is coming out to be almost 16%. So 16% weightage you give to the immediate period, second period. Now, first two period are counting almost 96% weightages. So what will be the weightage for the third period? It will be 0.8 into 0.2 into 0.2, right? So it is coming out to be almost 0.3%, 0.032. So 3% weightage. So this way you can distribute to the weightages. Actually, you are going back to the older data, and you are, for older data, the weightage will be reduced further, and it is reducing in an exponential manner. So that is what the exponential smoothing models. And also imagine that since you have given 80% weightage to the immediate period, your first three points, first three weightages are counting almost 99%, almost. So 96 plus 3, so almost 99.2%, imagine this. So this is what, you know, if you give higher weightage to the immediate period, you can see the percentage of distribution of your weight to the immediate data, immediate past data. Now, in case you give 20% weightage to the immediate period, so alpha equals to now 0.2. What does it mean? It means that you are not relying too much on immediate data. You are thinking that your old data has also good merit, and you want to distribute the weightage to the older data also. So you are relying on older data also, and you want to take a weighted combination of the older data, but in exponential manner. It will reduce. 20% will be the higher weightage to the immediate period, the maximum weightage you are giving to the immediate period. But that weightage not 80%, only 20%. Remaining 80% you are distributing to the older data. In that case, how the weightage will be distributed, let's see with some illustration, say. So 20% if you give to the immediate period, next period weightage will be 0.2 into 0.8. So it is coming out to be 16%. So first two period you are giving only 36%, imagine it. But you are distributing it. Now, third period, how much the wattage? Wattage will be 0.2 into 0.8 into 0.8. So it is coming out to be 12%. So effectively, how much wattage you have given to the first three period? 20% to the immediate period, 16% to the next period, 12% to the third period. So how much is the tentative weights total sum first three periods? So 36 plus 2, so 48. So 48% weightage you have given to the first three period, right? First three period. Rest 52% you are giving to the older period. Now compare the two cases. 0.8 to the immediate period, 80% weightage to the immediate period, and 20% weightage to the immediate period. What is the difference? If you give 80% weightage to the immediate period, you are, suppose data has a trend, or you are thinking that you should give higher importance to the, too much importance to the immediate data. Your example or say practical case or the context are like that. Suppose, you know, you have to give too much weightage to the immediate case. So if you give 80% weightage to the immediate data, you see first three period are accounting almost 99%. Remaining maybe you have 100 data, say you are in the middle of, say you are at 110th position. So 109 data are there, almost except three first three points. In case you are calculating 110th, so 106 data of older data are getting only 1% weightages. Imagine it. But first three period you are giving almost 99% weightages. But for the same problem, suppose if you want to give 20% to the immediate period, you are giving only 48% weightage to the immediate three period. But remaining 52% weightage you are distributing to the remaining older 106 data. So this is what the weight selection. So therefore, the formula we understood, the calculation process you understood, we may not require to follow this formula. We can directly use, as I mentioned, say yt plus 1 hat equals to alpha into yt actual plus 1 minus alpha into yt forecast. So this formula we can use in Excel because both are same. In the previous sheet I have told, I have discussed that both are same. Look at this formula and the extended formula, all are same. Anyone you can use. This is nothing but a representative of them actually. So any one of them you can follow. But because it's a inclusively included the older data. So we will follow in Excel the last one, the circle one that I have mentioned here. So let's go to the illustration now. The question here is that the selection of alpha is very crucial. So initially I have assumed 0.8. In the next illustration I have assumed 0.2 now. Now you might have a question that, sir, which alpha is best? Suppose there are so many participants in the course, and everybody will illustrate this problem with the same data. Suppose if I provide you the same data, say one data set of 100 data points or whatever, and if I ask you to use exponential smoothing, so which alpha to start with to the immediate period? It is true that we'll give higher weightage to the immediate period, but the distribution will be crucial. So in that case, how will finalize the best alpha? Will it vary from person to person, or it will be the same? Interestingly, we'll optimize the value of alpha. Initially, you can start with 0.8, you can start with 0.2, whatever initial value you can give to the immediate period, and the forecast you may get, that forecast is not the best. What you have to do, you have to calculate the error of the model that I discussed in the, you know, in the measure of accuracy session. So there, whatever RMSE or MSE or in the percentage, absolute percentage error, whatever MAD, whatever you take, you calculate that error. If your error is less or minimum and measure of accuracy is high, in that case, the corresponding alpha you have to select. That means you have to optimize the value of alpha. How to optimize the value of alpha and how to finalize the best alpha for everybody? That means all the participants for a single data sets will come up with the same alphas, unique alpha. There will be no variation in the alpha. For a given data set, everybody will come up with a unique alpha. We call it as optimum alpha. So how to optimize the value of alpha by giving some initial value, that we will discuss in the example. So let's see one illustrative example now. Suppose here, initially we have taken alpha 0.2 with the same data set that we have illustrated for name method as well as different type of moving average techniques. So same data sets I have taken, and initially suppose I can take a past tuple of data average to start with the first forecast, say period 2 or the initial period forecast to start my model. So there suppose I have taken the first period as the forecast for the second period. You can take the first couple of period average also. You can take average of, you know, first couple of period, and that you can put as the initial value forecast for the 2 or 5, whatever the period you want to start with the exponential smoothing model. So suppose this is the forecast for the second period. So now you have the actual data of second period. Look at actual data of second period and forecast data of second period. Now you use the formula. What is the formula that I talked about? Yt forecast, say plus 1 equals to alpha into yt actual plus 1 minus alpha into yt forecast. So for second period, suppose for third period, what will be the forecast? Alpha say 0.2, 0.2 into what is the second period actual? 24 plus 1 minus 0.2, say 0.8 into what is the second period forecast? We have already assumed it by considering the previous period as it is or the average of couple of first period to start with. So here it is coming 23. So this is coming out to be, say, it is coming to be 23.20. So this is the forecast for the third period. Look at this is the forecast for third period. Exponential smoothing, you understood now? This is what the model of exponential smoothing. Then you drag this, you freeze your alpha value and you drag the formula, you will get the forecast for the forthcoming period. For example, suppose you want to predict the 18th period forecast. How will you get it? I will illustrate in Excel, but here you quickly you can get to know. So Y18 forecast will be alpha, say 0.2 into 17th period actual. What is the 17th period actual? 25. Plus 0.8, the weighted combination of the 17th period forecast. How much you got by dragging the formula? You got 26.43. So it is coming out to be 26.14. Done. You got the forecast of 18th period, which actually company want or your data sets required. So you got the forecast. But that is not best because this is the calculation I have explained. But this forecast you found for which alpha? That you have given for any iteration you have given to the immediate period, the weightage is 20%. The remaining 80% you are distributing to the older, or you can say the weighted combination of actual and forecast. But this alpha is not the best. We have to finalize the best alpha. And look at, if you calculate the absolute error, mean MAD, so here the error, the gap, the deviation yt minus yt hat, if you take this error, we have calculated all the error here, like the in the previous sessions I have discussed detail about it. And then square up like absolute value and the average is coming out to be, I think we have sub 16 data sets. So MAD is coming out to 2.26, MAP percentage absolute we are getting 8% almost, and MAC we are getting 10. Remember, for that data in exponential smoothing you found suppose 6 point something, right, or 9 point something. MAC percentage absolute error was around mean absolute percentage error around 6%, and here it is 8%. So we can say that moving average model was better for this data actually. But it is not that, you know, we have not optimized this, right? It's for 0.2. Once you will optimize the value of smoothing constant or alpha, probably you may get the better error or measure of accuracy through the exponential smoothing model. We'll conclude that later. We'll do the comparison analysis also. And RMAC will be the square root of MAC, so you are getting 3.16 for alpha 0.2. Now if we extend alpha 0.2 to 0.8 with the illustration that I have talked about, look at the, I'll come to that, but look at here the 0.2 explanation in the graph. So suppose you are making forecast, say, on this period, you are taking only the previous period and the corresponding weight, the initial assumption, say, same as it is. And then for this period forecast, you have taken the previous period actual and the weighted combination of forecast. So these two data you have taken, and you have the actual and forecast, and you got the forecast for the third period. And then for fourth period, you are taking actually, now for fourth period, what you are doing? You are actually for fourth period forecast, you are taking alpha percentage of actual plus 1 minus alpha of this forecast value. And you are getting that. And you drag it, you will get the forecast through exponential smoothing model. To some extent, it's quite good. It's very popular in industry also. Now, I was talking about 0.8. So for 0.2 illustration, I have shown you the table and also the graph. But for 0.8, I'll show you in Excel. But if you see the final graph for both the cases, look at here. So 0.8, which says a green color, look at 0.8 is the green color, and 0.2 is the red one, say. Look at the differences. 0.8 to the immediate period means what? We are giving higher weightage to the immediate period. Look at the trend of the green line. It is following similar pattern of the graph. Look at the black one, the actual one. And it is 0.8 is also following similar pattern because 80% weightage you have given to the immediate period. So it is following the similar pattern. But when you give 0.2, look at that, it is averaging out with the older data because you are giving importance to the immediate data. In every case, whether 0.8 or 0.2, you are reducing the weightage in exponential manner. The weightage are been decreasing in exponential manner. But since you are giving higher weightage to the immediate period, look at the changes in the graph. So it's depending on the problem and the statement and the context you have to finalize alpha. Don't worry, you don't have to finalize alpha. You just start with any alpha. You go to the Excel and optimization solver or any Python code, you will get the best alpha or optimum alpha for the data series. Let's go to the Excel now and then illustrate this whatever we have done today for exponential smoothing model with the numerical examples. Okay, so I believe you can see the Excel sheet. So here if you see the Excel data, same data sets I have taken, and I'll make the forecast for 18th period. But initial period, I'll start from the second period. I have assumed that the forecast for the second period is nothing but the same as first period. I told you you can take the average, of first couple of period also. You can take the average of first couple of period and that you can bring here. Otherwise, same data you can take also, which I have done here. So now this is a forecast for the second period. And now for third period onwards, your actual calculation will start. So how will get this third period forecast? Look at alpha 0.2 I have taken. 0.2 into second period actual 24 plus 0.8 into 23, which is a forecast for second period using the formula. Look at in the right hand side, I have mentioned the color formula. So this weighted combination I have taken and I found this forecast. For example, for illustration, suppose we are at 11th period, right? And I'll show you how we calculated the forecast for the 11th period. Suppose we are at 11th period. So I'll show you the calculation. Suppose here, forecast for the 11th period. What is the alpha? 0.2. Into what is the forecast for 10th period? T, look at T, you are at YT plus on 11th period. So 10th period actual plus 1 minus alpha into the 10th period forecast using the exponential smoothing, you already got it. You take that forecast and you enter it. You got the forecast for actually 11th period. We found the forecast of 11th period, which is nothing but 26.82. So this way you drag it, you'll get the formula. You drag this formula, we'll get the forecast for all the forthcoming period. And for 18th period forecast, you found 26.14. Whatever the forecast we found, that is not a matter. You calculate the RMSE or the error part, because measure of accuracy is the crucial part of your model. So here if you see the error I have taken and absolute value we have calculated and MAD I have calculated as average of them. We have discussed detail, I am not repeating that. Similarly, percentage error, absolute error by actual data, relative value you can calculate, multiply by 100. You can get the MAP, and the average of MAP is coming out to be 8% here. And if you go to the square error, mean square error, here we are getting almost average value, almost 10, right? And RMSE is 3.16. Now, this forecast you found for alpha 0.2. If you change it to 0.8, how much you are getting? Your MAC has come down. Look at 9.80 and RMSE is 3.13. Whatever the forecast you are getting, said earlier it was 26 point something, now 25.55, that is not a matter. Matter is that how much your RMSE or error part, MAC part or percentage error part. So for point, say 0.5, you are getting different forecast and the RMSE different and MAC also different. So which alpha is best for this particular data sets which has been kept in column number D? So let's see. So the corresponding forecast of period 18 we may get finally. So let's go to the data and go to the solver. How to install solver and how to run it, how to put the data, import the data into solver, I have discussed in the previous sessions. So I'm not going to repeat that, just see how we are getting the optimum value. So we have selected RMSE as our objective function and it's a minimization problem. So we'll select the minimum cell and then the decision variables are alpha. We have to optimize that alpha value. So we'll select this particular cell and then the conditions we'll add. The alpha should be 0 to 1, right? So I have put that, look at the conditions, alpha 0 to 1. How to add this? You can go to change or add. We can do it. Alpha should be less than, greater than, whatever integer, binary, whatever you want to put. Here it is less than 1, okay, and alpha should be greater than 1. We can click here also, variables cannot be negative. So you can click this non-negativity conditions, and it is a non-linear problem. It is not a linear simplex algorithm. It's not a linear problem because MAC and RMSE are a non-linear form. So you have to select non-linear gradient method of non-linear process, which has been developed by Microsoft. Don't select the simplex LP. You have to select the nonlinear problem because it's a RMSE is a nonlinear. So solve it. Look at the optimum alpha we found, how much? 45% to the immediate period for this data set, wherever in your iteration, 11th period, 3rd period, 18th period, your immediate period weightage you are giving 45%. Rest, you know, 55% weightage you are distributing to the older data. And this is the exponential smoothing formula of time series analysis. And you got the best RMSE and the corresponding forecast here. Look at, you cannot get lower than this RMSE or MSE value. You put any alpha, let us put 0.8, you are getting 3.13, which is higher than the optimum RMSE. You put, suppose if you put 0.8 and if you go to data again, if you solve it, we will come up with the best alpha. Solver will search all options of alpha between 0 to 1 and they will come up with the best alpha. And they are giving the optimum output actually and the corresponding forecast. This is what the exponential smoothing model. Remember, in the beginning of exponential smoothing concept, I talked about that you have to optimize alpha. Initially, all the participants can start with any alpha. Look at any alpha, you can start with any alpha. 0.2, you put 0.2, not a matter, it will go up. Go to data and you optimize. Solver will find the best optimum value of alpha and the corresponding RMSE. So everywhere you are getting the best optimum value, and all the participants, if you practice with any problem with this Excel illustration, with the formula, iterative process, or in Python also, you will get the best alpha or optimum alpha or unique alpha for everybody for the same series of data. If you change the data sets, your alpha will change definitely because the pattern, the behavior of the data will change. So corresponding alpha will be the different, but you have to optimize it. Initially you can start with anyone, but the optimum alpha you have to finalize through this optimum process of iteration. So this is what the exponential smoothing model. Now let us come back to the PPT, then I will discuss one interesting concept now, that we understood the exponential smoothing model, right? And the optimum alpha for a given data set, how to select the optimum alpha, that also we illustrated using Excel of the data. We finalized it. Now let's see one drawback of the exponential smoothing model, that if the data has a high uptrend or downtrend pattern, that means suppose data has a uptrend pattern or say downtrend pattern. Suppose you have a uptrend pattern of data, suppose. In that case, this exponential smoothing formula give, if you find say alpha say 0.2 or say 0.5, say if you select alpha, in that case, what happens? It will smooth out the data and the forecast might be like this. If you put higher alpha, say 0.8, it might forecast like this to some extent. But it may not come like this. It will not go in the trend of the data. It may not capture the trend of the data effectively. So therefore, exponential smoothing has a drawback or limitation if the data has a strong uptrend or downtrend. To some extent, steady data, stationary data, if you have, this model is very good. I have shown you the illustration. But look at this sample example. Suppose you have a data, say sales of a product month-wise in a decreasing manner, right? So in January, it is 1325, but in May, it is 1210. There is a strong decrease. In February, it is high, but overall, if you see the pattern of the data, look at this black cell data, black graph data, the actual data, it's a downtrend data, right? So there is a solid downtrend. Can we use the exponential smoothing model that we discussed today? Look at moving average models will also not fit for this particular data sets. We have discussed that also. Which model is most suitable for that data, we'll discuss in the next session. But today, let us understand the drawback of exponential smoothing model. So can we use exponential smoothing for this model? The answer is no. Why? Look at that. We have selected alpha 0.2, that means immediate period for the month of May. For the month of May, we have given 20% weightages. Remaining 80% we have smoothed out. So here, if you see the data, the forecast is coming using exponential smoothing. I'll show you in Excel. The forecast is 1309. Is it a good forecast? Look at there is a downtrend in the data, and your May for May actually is 1210. Your June should be lower than 1200, right? So it could be say 1200 or 11 something something. But you are getting 1309 with this exponential smoothing model of 20% to the May data. Remaining 80% you are giving to the older data. So therefore, you are giving importance to the February, March data also. Therefore, this model is coming up with ending up with a forecast of 1309. But look at the graph, 1309. But you will find a big error, right? Big error. The RMSE will be quite high. Now, if you increase alpha 0.8, the way we have discussed in the previous examples, If you select alpha point 8, look at 80% weightage you are giving to the month of May. 80% weightage you are giving to the month of May data. So in that case, what happens? Your forecast is to some extent better than 0.2. How much? 12.25. So that means higher alpha is better if you have a trend uptrend or downtrend data. Look at here, for 0.8, your forecast is this. To some extent, you know, maybe your actual will be like this. Say, to some extent, quite better with 0.8, the error is less. Less error you are getting, right? So therefore, which alpha is the best, 0.2 or 0.8? Let's go to Excel and illustrate this particular example, and let's see what alpha the optimum solver gives to us. Go to Excel again, and I have written the data here. And if you see, enter data I have kept here, and I will make a forecast using this exponential smoothing model. Initially, I have kept 0.2, right? Same formula as it is. RMEC I have calculated. I will go to data. To save the time, I have done enter calculation, and I will show you the solution only. Go to solver, same like alpha range, optimum value, enter inputting of the data I have done, nonlinear optimization, as it is, I will solve it. Look at, RMEC is 43 and alpha is 1. So look at the forecast, it is ending up with the same method, like name method kind of thing. Same data it is forecasted. It has not smoothed out with the older data. Exponential smoothing is failed here, actually. It is not taking the weighted combination in an exponential manner with the older data. It is ending up with the just immediate period. 100% weightage they have given to the immediate period. So this is the drawback of the model if you have uptrend or downtrend data. So let us see with 0.8 also. If you start with 0.8 and if you solve it again, look at here. Again, it is ending up with alpha 1. Since alpha cannot be 1.2, say, alpha range is, say, if you put 120%, you might get a better forecast. But you cannot increase alpha more than 1, right? So range is 0 to 1. So it is ending up with alpha 1. And it is providing like a name method forecast kind of thing. No exponential smoothing has been done. No weighted average has been taken into account. Just past period has been taken into consider as a forecast for the succeeding period. And this is what the drawback of the exponential smoothing models. So then how to overcome it? Because if there is an uptrend or downtrend data, it is saying that, you know, exponential smoothing cannot make better forecast because there is a limitations. You cannot increase alpha more than 1. And it is ending up with alpha 1. So probably here with alpha 1, you can see 12.10. But perhaps I will show you tomorrow the Hold model, which is extension of this concept. You will get the forecast will be like 11.65 or maybe 11.75 something. So this type of forecast will come with the data pattern actually. How we'll get this new forecast? Actual value we'll get to know once we'll open the actual forecast value using Hold model. But just tentatively I'm talking about, it will be below actually 1200, maybe 1190 or 1180 kind of thing will come as a forecast. How come you will get, and what will be the corresponding alpha and the corresponding trend part you have to consider and you have to take into account? How to do that? That we'll discuss in the next session through Hold model. So let's come back to the, you know, PPT now. So today, let me go back to the summary sheet. Today we have discussed only the concept of exponential smoothing model, simple exponential smoothing model, how it works, what is the features of it, how it has been derived, and how it can be calculated, and the corresponding smoothing constant can be optimized. That we have found, we understood. Next class, what we'll do, we'll extend the exponential smoothing concept to Hold model when there is an uptrend or downtrend data. So let's conclude today's session with these discussions.